Now, other method to change the synchronous speed, as it is evident from this equation, is that if we change the number of stator poles. So if we have two separate windings on the stator of the induction motor, then we can have such winding that both the windings will have some separate number of poles. And so if we supply to winding 1, then speed will be ns1, which is as per 120 f by t1, and if we give supply to the winding 2, which gives us a separate amount of number of poles, then the speed will be ns2, which is equal to 120 f upon p2. Now we can also do such a thing that when we combine both the windings, when we give supply to both the windings, then in that case we can have a different combined number of poles for both the windings, for which we will have a third speed. So in that way we can run such kind of motor with three different speeds based on the number of poles made by the two separate windings, single alone and the third as a combination of both of them. But this increases the size of the stator of the induction motor and thus the entire induction motor. So it is very rarely used method. Okay.